Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about the embedded 3D motion content packs in Cartoon Animator 4, where you can find them, and how you can use them. In the newest version, there are 5 dummy characters embedded, each with a different angle profile. You can find them under Actor, Actor Template, Character, G3360 Human, and Dummy for 3D Motion. On the top right of every thumbnail, you can find icons indicating that they are 360 head characters. There's also a symbol below that, indicating that the character has a bone hand, which you can see in action here. In the G3360 Human folder, you'll find 2 back-facing Roger dummies. What we're going to do next is show how to apply a 3D motion to these dummies. As you may have gathered from our other 3D motion converter and motion link tutorials, the proper procedure is to convert these motions via dummy G3 characters in order to account for different body proportions when applying them to other G3 characters. Let's go find our 3D motions now. You'll find these under Animation, Animation Template, Motion, and 3D Motion. There are a bunch of embedded 3D motions here, including things like Walk, Idle, and Dance. By using these motions in combination with the 3D motion converter, you can easily apply them to your 2D G3 characters to create multi-angle performances. There are also a bunch of new 2D motions, which you can find in the Animation tab under Perform and in the From 3D Motion folder. You'll notice each one contains a combination of characters on the top left, which indicate the angle profile of that particular motion. F indicates that you need to apply the motion to a front-facing character. S means you need to apply it to a 45-degree angle character. And S2 is for side-facing characters at 90 degrees. There are also 2 back-facing profiles, with BS standing for 135 degrees from front-facing, and B standing for completely back-facing at 180 degrees from the camera. If you see straight lines on a thumbnail, that means that the motion will contain forward or backward movement. If we apply this one without the straight lines, you'll see that the character won't move forward on the Z-axis towards the camera. However, if we apply this other motion with straight lines on the thumbnail, you can see that our character will approach the camera, moving forward on the Z-axis. This goes for side-facing motions as well, as you can see here. It's also important to note that these motions all contain bone hand animations. If you attempt to apply them to a character with sprite hands, you'll encounter a warning message. To ensure that your character has bone hands, first select it and then go into Composer mode. You can then go into the Hands folder in the Body tab, where you'll find your bone hands for this character under the G3360 Human subfolder. Once they're applied, we can exit Composer mode and apply this front-facing change pose animation to test them out. You'll notice that the results may not be ideal on the hands, as it appears like the thumbs are too far out and our character has a grabbing gesture. So let's take a look at how to refine them. To refine individual hand bones, we can open up the 2D motion key editor. In this case, we can select the thumb bones from the main view. When you do this, make sure that you're at frame 1 and have selected part enabled in the set key options. Now, when we play back, you'll see that the thumbs are in a more reasonable position and the results have improved. However, the hands are still a bit too far inward when they're supposed to be on the character's hips, so let's adjust that too. We'll once again open the 2D motion key editor, and this time we're going to set full body keys at both the beginning and end of this motion to ensure that all our edits are contained within these 2 keyframes and don't affect anything outside. Then at frame 200, where my character's hands are too close together, I'm going to switch back to selected part in the set key options and move both hands further away to place them approximately on the hips. Once I've done that, I need to quickly scrub through the timeline to all the other subsequent areas where the hand position may be a little bit off and adjust those as well. When we finally get to the end of the timeline, we can play back and see our completed fixed motion. Finally, we're going to take a look at aligning a motion. Let's first apply a walking motion with forward movement to this character. You can see the yellow clip in the motion track appears. If we copy this clip and paste it to the end of the first one, what's going to happen is that our character will move forward and then snap back to the origin of the motion again. This is because both clips contain the same root information where the movement starts. Therefore, we need to realign the second clip. We can do so by right-clicking on that motion clip at any point and going to Align and then to Hip. What that does is it aligns the character's position at the beginning of this clip with the same hip position as he had at the end of the first one. Now when we play back, you'll see that we have a seamless walk forward. If you want to learn more about converting 3D motions to your 2D characters and have more content to explore with, you can check out the 3D to 2D Learn by Example Motion Sampler, which provides you with a total collection of 80 motions optimized for your G3 characters. That's about all the time I have for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and as always, check out our forums and Learning Center for new videos and information, and I'll see you in the next video.